Alright folks, welcome back to the Don's channel. I am the Don Father and I'm about to do a reaction for a patron of ours, Austin Aginski from Canada. Thanks very much, Austin, for the support and the request. I know you've been busy working, you said that in the message, so I hope you'll enjoy this reaction. You've requested the life story of Charles Humphrey Keaton IV, condensed version. I know there's a longer one available on YouTube, but when you're doing reactions, it's nice to have a shorter video. It makes it a lot easier to do a reaction, and it doesn't take up most of your day trying to record it, edit it, etc., and upload it. But I'm sure it's a decent, a fantastic story, and it's a decent video the way they've done it. It does say condensed version, so I'd imagine they get all the main talking points that you need to know about this man's life story. The link to the original video then will be in the description section below, as will our Patreon account if you'd like to become a patron and get a personalised video request and shout out. Please check that out there too, or simply join the channel as a member and get your request through that way. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment and share, and put the bell on. Thanks very much. Anyway, no more talking. Let's go!
Today, a Navy SEAL was killed in combat against ISIS in Iraq. On
US ISIS fighters killing Charles Keating yesterday during a firefight in Iraq.
Honored for the hero he is. Tributes being made in his memory
Charlie
all over our
state. Charlie fulfilled his life goal of serving our country.
His death got a lot of attention because of his name. But when you find out who C4 was and how he lived his 31 years, you owe him not just attention, but as the governor of Arizona said, our thoughts, prayers, and eternal gratitude.
You know, as a baby, I just remember him, a ball of energy even from the time he was born.
He had the biggest lips and the biggest mouth of any baby I've ever seen in my life. He was always proud of himself for being able to put the bottom of a Gatorade bottle in his mouth. But he was really the cutest thing.
Had unlimited energy. We had a trampoline in the backyard, and they would jump on that trampoline every night for 3 or 4 hours. It would never end, and I'd have to jump with them.
We were explorers, me, Brian, and Charlie. We were always up to something, and we were always into trouble. He was a prodigy at pretty much everything that he did, so he's always better than me at running.
I started coaching Charlie probably in about sixth grade, and I worked with him all the way up through high school. I figured I'd probably see about 300 kids a year, and if you do the math, that's about 10,000 kids. Charlie, out of those 10,000, is definitely the most memorable one.
Charlie was like top 10 in the nation his freshman year of high school.
He was always my number one runner.
Of course, everybody wanted Charlie on their team because he was always the fastest.
But he was one of those guys hugely about team. You know, some guys at times the number one would finish his race and he'd go off and he'd be done. Charlie would always turn around and go, hey, come on, and clap for the guy behind him, the second place, whatever, and make sure they made it in. Because he wanted his team to do well. It wasn't just all about Charlie.
He was always positive, always had a great outlook.
Who doesn't want to, you know, be around a person like that and call someone like that your friend?
Everybody called him his best friend. He has like 500 best friends.
A lot of people call Charlie their best friend.
You know, he was lovable, he was memorable. You know, he lit up a room when he walked into it. For Charlie, I struggle to remember a bad day for Charlie. But I do remember the morning practice where he was probably the most serious was, it was 9/11. You know, he really made a decision, I think, at that moment to move forward and say, I gotta help my country out.
He always did have the guiding principles with his obligation or his sense of duty, but 9/11 was a turning point where it went from an idea to being real.
He said, Mom, I'm going to go to Bud's. And I said, okay.
That's kind of how it started. He moved to Coronado and immediately went into the team program.
He wanted to be with the best of the best, and that's why he joined the teams.
He was standing behind me in the chow hall, and me and him always talked in line. We're not supposed to talk in line. And it's called an RPOC. He's like the head guy in boot camp. And he's like, if you guys stop talking, you can stand in the front of the line the rest of the time in boot camp. And me and Charlie looked at each other, and we just went straight to the back line. Out of that first boot camp of 80 guys, only 5 of us actually made it. He was a good partner to have when times were really hard. We just started busting up laughing, and it kind of just clicks you out of it. Some people didn't thought it was like, is this guy being sarcastic? He always has a grin on his face, and no, he's just happy to be here, happy to be a Navy SEAL, happy to be wherever he is, you know, doing what he's doing.
You having fun?
Oh yeah.
He loved being a sniper, even though he had the shakiest hands in NSW. He drank more Pepsi than I think is healthy for a person to drink. He had two hats, Fun Charlie and All Business.
We deployed January, February of 2016, and he went to Iraq, and then I went to the United Arab Emirates.
Up until that point, not a lot had been going on, because it was a defined line of where the good guys were and where the bad guys were.
Everybody told me how difficult it can kind of be while they're on deployment. He was so good. He talked to me all the time, and he told me all the stories that were going on there, and asked about home.
He would call me every single day. You know, we have a large family, so there's always a lot to talk about.
He was really, really close with his family. He was always talking to him on deployment.
Charlie is all about family. Always was. Loves his big family. And when he joined the team, he was part of a bigger family.
I always thought people that were in his platoon or sent overseas with him were lucky to be with him.
I stand my post.
We had received word from the Kurds that there are a lot of ISIS guys getting ready to attack a position. Chuck had figured that if they were gonna attack an area, this would be the best place to be.
They were overrun by probably 125, 130 ISIS guys.
We end up dropping a bomb, but it missed. And they start running at us, and then kicked it off from there.
They're coming from everywhere. Hey,
right.
His battlefield geography and awareness were just incredible.
I got another guy in the middle of the town.
He knew where to put guys.
I want guns this way also.
He knew how to lead. And the most important thing is he was so calm. He was just having a good time. He was like, you're gonna be fine.
Make sure we're not getting fucked
up. Kind of got everyone on the same page, which is hard when there's a massive language barrier. The Kurds were super stoked because we kind of saved their ass.
He loved the Kurds and was really proud to support the Kurdish people. One of the reasons he joined the SEAL teams is he thought he could do a lot of good, help a lot of people, and he did. Charlie was awarded the Navy Cross for the actions of the battle on March 4th. I could tell he was really proud of himself for what he had done. And it made me happy that he was that proud of himself and proud of his guys that were with him.
And so proud of the things that he did and how humble he was about it.
You're always gonna have your back, and you know you're gonna have a good time for sure. Charlie would always be the first one in the fight and always be the first one to have a crack of beer with you. But he was always the first one to be where he needed to be.
He was fearless, but he was, the more crazy it was, the happier he was.
It was difficult whenever he had to go into like a combat situation because you knew who he was and he wasn't ever gonna hold back.
We Skyped, and I told him what the firefight that he got in before that, what he got his Navy Cross for, and I was like, just told him to be careful, and. That's the last time I talked to him.
Petty Officer First Class Charles Keating responded to a call for help from Kurdish allies and American advisors who were being overrun by ISIS.
Our own guys were in a position where they needed help. Right when they called us and like, we need you now. You know, Chuck's like, get in the car, we're going. We went into this city, Taliskov. The ISIS guys had broken through the front line and took over this town. By the time we got to our position, they were in this pretty gnarly fight. The best guys in firefights will always be in the most dangerous spots because they're also the best spots. Like, someone has to take them, and that's exactly what he did. He put himself in a pretty dangerous spot. Eventually, they're kind of getting overwhelming fire, so they kind of got shot off the roof, and just one round just caught them. on the inside of his plate.
And we got the call. It was like, I mean, somebody who you thought was invincible. I didn't want it to be true.
Fuck, man.
Charles Keating IV. Charlie, Chuck, or C4, was born into a family of veterans, all-American athletes and Olympians, even a gold medalist. So naturally, Charlie and the love of his life, Brooke, celebrated their anniversary on the 4th of July. She called him the huge goofball everybody wanted to be friends with. The adventurer who surfed and spearfished and planned to sail around the world. When the Twin Towers fell, he was in high school and he decided to enlist. Join the SEALs because he told his friends it was the hardest thing to do. He deployed to Afghanistan and three times to Iraq, earning a Bronze Star for Valor. And earlier this month, while assisting local forces in Iraq who had come under attack, he gave his life. A few days later, one of his platoon mates sent Charlie's parents a letter from Iraq.
Please tell everyone Chuck saved a lot of lives today, it said. Partner force fled, Navy SEALs held the line. Chuck was leading the fight as always. He went unconscious with that big signature smile on his handsome face as always. Chuck was full of aloha, but also a ferocious warrior who killed dozens of Daesh today to save his brothers. Long live the Brotherhood. That means, to a father, that means a lot. Because I think that's what's important to Charlie, you know?
Chuck was full of aloha, but was also a ferocious warrior. So today we honor Chief Special Warfare Officer Charles Keating IV.
Charlie Keating IV!
Booyah, Charlie Keating IV!
Whoa. Now that's the end of the video. God bless you, Charlie. What a man. What an unbelievable outlook on life. Such a positive vibe about him. Everybody loved being around him. Everybody wanted to be near him. Infectious personality. Always doing things with a smile, even in the most horrific of situations where you're in a severe gunfight, people are panicking, he manages to remain calm and control everybody. Leaders step up in times like that. You don't demand respect, you command respect, and it'll naturally come, and he seemed to be able to do that with great ease. Fierce athlete, comes from a line of athletes, etc. You heard gold medalist, veterans, etc. What a the size of that family, incredible. It's quite strange that you would get a massive group of family like that together quite regular and not fight like mad, but they all seem to have a great relationship with one another, and Charlie was very much family orientated man. He just threw himself head first into absolutely everything. That's what it seemed, no matter what it was. Yep, I'll do that. You could just tell by him those wouldn't want to say no to everything. Just give everything a go and give it your best and try your best and enjoy it as best you can. And as all of his teammates have said, all the people that have served alongside him, all his family said, and he just did everything with this massive ear-to-ear smile like a Cheshire cat. But the soldier then, or the SEAL, I should say, wow, fantastic. You know, when they were in peril, he didn't even think twice, did he? He was like, I'm going there and we're helping. Get into the vehicles and let's mount up, let's go right now, without even thinking, let's just go. And sadly, that was how he happened to lose his life, saving fellow fighters, soldiers, marines, whoever they all were there. I don't know, it seems to be quite a bit of a mix. I love the message that they've said there about his respect for the Kurds. I absolutely love the Kurds as well. Brilliant fighters, and the women as well, the Kurdish women, so brave, and in some cases possibly even better than the men, what they had to endure with ISIS. But sadly, that was to be Charlie's last moment of his life. But it was one of which his family can be so proud, because he actually died trying to save others. And the words in that there were just incredible. As a father, you've seen what his son meant to him, so very, very proud of him. His teammates as well, loved him, proud of him, and of course he'll be a huge loss, not only to his fellow SEALs, but also his family and friends that he had as well. So, what a story, by the way, what a man, to be able to get your story said by President Obama as well, and recognition for your valour, for your bravery, for your pretty much your life story as well, just your personality and your character is just absolutely brilliant. Too often we have stories about famous people getting awards, and it's very, very relevant here in the UK. Anybody getting knighthoods or OBEs or MBEs is usually sports stars or actors or famous people. It's very rare that you get moments like that where it's all about somebody who served their country. There needs to be more of that. They are the true heroes, not sports stars that kick a bit of leather about a football field or can sing well or act pretty good in a movie that you once liked. That is an absolute nonsense. We need to get our priorities in check and realise when the going gets tough, and you need people to step forward and defend you, it's people like Charlie that matter. Not those in Hollywood, not those in the music industry, not those who pull on the shirt of your favourite sports team. They don't matter at all. It's heroes like Charlie. Gone, but never forgotten. God bless you, Charlie. Thanks very much for the request, Austin. Boy, I nearly cried through that. Really emotional. What a guy. The link to the original video will be in the description section below, as will our Patreon account. If you'd like a personalised video request and shout out, please do so by checking that out, or simply join the channel as a member and get your request through that way. Thanks very much for watching, everyone. I am the Dawn Father, and I'll see you all soon. Goodbye.